What's good? What's good? What's good? Let's talk about it. A lot of people was asking me about Ja Morant's situation. And basically the situation with the Grizzlies. Why they skipped media day? See, you know, why did they face the music? They did all that talking. Then they act like they want to smoke. But then when the smoke comes, they don't want to deal with it. First of all, y'all are getting real delusional when it comes to LeBron James and the Lakers. Like, y'all are blind as to what's going on out there on the court, or you didn't see the game. And I'm taking many of you didn't, because if you saw the game, you would have saw this is not a game you should be bragging about. This is not a game you should be saying, oh, this is what I want. This is not that kind of game. So when you look at the scenarios and you look at the situations that are in place and that's involved, period, you say to yourself, damn, well, I don't think this is the one, or this is it. This is not about basketball. This is about what the public want to see. The Grizzlies are the bad guys. The Lakers are the good guys. We got to let the good guys win. This is not about basketball. And if I'm Ja Morant, I don't want no parts of this. I don't want to play part in saying anything that they say. They're going to turn it into a battle against them when they're not playing the Los Angeles Lakers. They're playing against the league, the NBA. The NBA does not want the Memphis Grizzlies to win a championship. They don't want them to ever compete for one. They're there to be the guys to draw all the attention, but then that's it. They're to fade away into a memory. They don't want you to know the Grizzlies. They don't care if the Grizzlies work hard. They don't care that they one of the best basketball teams in the league. You think the NBA cares about that? They don't care. All they care about is for you to be food for the Los Angeles Lakers. And we got to give them 10 free throws in a row. If we got to give them every opportunity in the book to make it, we're going to carry this team because the league needs them. That team is inferior. That's a 500 basketball club with a dinosaur at the helm, and we got to sit there and endure this. Why? Why do we got to do it? Give that assignment to somebody else. Why do we got to sit there and suffer? You see, that's what the gist of the story is. Is how long do we got to sit here and endure this crap? It don't make any sense for us. It don't make any sense for me. Because I like basketball, but I don't like the foolery. I don't like the notion that this is the best it's ever going to get. I hate that because this is clearly not the best it's going to get. And that they're clearly not the best team in basketball. They're just being carried. And for these pompous fans who sit around and can't and act like they don't see what they see, I just can't deal with you. I can't even discuss basketball if you're going to omit the fact of what's happening on the court. First of all, I could never go to a basketball game, watch the game, and act like I didn't see what I saw. Well, Ja Morant is fed up. You know, he's very upset about what he called missed calls. This has been going on for years. Ja Morant has never really, you know, loved the way they officiated. This has been going on for like 2 years. And they always tell Ja, hey, man, you got to pay your dues. Pay your dues, young buck. Pay your dues. That's what they tell him. So you can't get a foul call because, you know, he said he went through it with the first time he really imploded was the Clippers game. But it had happened like 3-4 times prior in different games. And this is how players get injured. And now since the incident he had back in March with the Colorado police, all this nonsense, you know, you got Tony Brothers, the referee that threw him out about a week ago. Here we are. Right? You got the Guardian calling Ja Morant a wannabe gangster. This is before this matchup. A month ago, back in March, LeBron shows wannabe gangster Ja Morant that a gun doesn't make you great. What? What? So this is bigger than... This is bigger than just the Grizzlies versus the Lakers. This is political. This is nonsense. When they're just basketball players, they just want to play ball. But it's not about a game anymore. It's about all this nonsense and this BS. Dylan Brooks is the villain. Dylan the villain. And he's trying to embrace what the media is already trying to label them as. And it's sad because here it is. You have Desmond Bane, a great basketball player. You have Jackson Jr. who just got Defensive Player of the Year, had his breakout season this year. You've seen a bunch of young players on this team stick together and come together as a team. You have Roddy, a rookie who has stepped up tremendously and getting major playing time as a rookie, you know, on a championship caliber team. And he's an intricate part of the offense, and he's been guarding LeBron James a lot to keep the foul trouble away from Dylan Brooks. Well, if you go back and look at all the narratives that's involved, what would you see as a common denominator? What I see as a common denominator is that the league has been doing this for years. It's just that now the internet has become the media. This was happening back in the 80s and 90s. We didn't have a voice. We didn't have anybody to step up and say, hey, this is some bullshit. We didn't have anybody in the media that could say that. So the press got to write what they wanted to write, say what they wanted to say, and only the people who were screaming from their homes could not go out and reach millions. So the masses couldn't hear the outrage from the people. But they felt it because they driven away their target audience. You're telling your public to follow a team of a 38-year-old man, a dinosaur in this game. Let's follow this dinosaur on his journey to try to win a title from being in the slums. Since this whole storyline of the NBA is written for this dinosaur to come up and do what he's doing. So let's watch the aging dinosaur. Then when the dinosaur leaves or whatever and gets his swan song, oh, now let's look at the other guys. And they're going to be like, nah, we wanted the dinosaur story. Okay, thanks. And then they turn away. And the reason why they turn away is because you didn't spend any time during that whole stanza of promoting your talent. This is the problem of the league when you don't develop your talent. David Stern knew better, saying you can't sit there and keep putting this overrated player and overinflated guy in the NBA Finals every year. You can't keep doing that. If you keep milking the cow, and said, oh, well, the people still show up to watch the games because you promoted it. But the game is crap. So now that the game is crap and then the people are watching it, they're like, oh, this is ridiculous. This team's getting robbed for this guy? It doesn't make any sense. So what you're doing is putting yourself and setting yourself up for disaster. Really, I just have a hard time understanding why. I really do have a hard time trying to understand why. So, that's that. I'm done with the whole NBA if they let LeBron James walk away with a championship. That would be the ultimate insult to me, my intelligence, everything. That cannot happen. Because the Los Angeles Lakers are what you would call an inferior team. They're inferior. And the fact that I feel that this is a 500 ball club compared to a Grizzlies team that is light years better than them. I'm just sick of the narratives of we got to try to cripple all these other teams so that LeBron James can win. That narrative has got to stop because you're killing your league. You're killing the whole notion of what basketball is supposed to be about. But they don't want Ja Morant to win because Fox News ripped him. Yeah, Major League Baseball stars who ain't got nothing to do with the situation ripping Ja Morant. Ja Morant posted a gun on the internet, so of course the Grizzlies not going to beat the Lakers. Who's going to do that? Then you got Richard Jefferson. Well, he's in media now, but he's going to rip them and snub them for not talking to the media. And after they lost the game, why would they talk to the media? Talking about, you can't talk all that talk and then not walk the walk. Dylan Brooks, as much as we crack jokes, I love his fire. I love the energy. If you're not going to talk to the media at the Tuesday games, that to me is cowardice. I don't believe either of them are cowards. I'm not saying that. I'm saying to avoid that smoke. After they talk the talk, you can't avoid the media. Yeah, they can. They're not avoiding the media for the reasons you think, Richard Jefferson. It's not unacceptable. Dylan Brooks is not, if it's in his contract, he does not have to participate. Or he's going to just pay the fine. And just pay the fine. Well, when you look at the end result of the products, or you look at the end design of where something should be and where it isn't, the imperfections of the teams, I'm not saying the Grizzlies are the greatest team in the league, but they're one of the best teams in basketball. It's just that they get screwed out of games. And down the stretch, guys panic because these guys are young and they don't know how to say, okay, the league is finna screw me over here. I can't just run into people. I just gotta actually, they're not gonna give it to me. If you run into LeBron James, they're gonna give the call to LeBron James. Okay, that's just the way it is. You know that you're gonna start have to working on pull-up jump shots. You're gonna have to do something else. You know, when the Pistons went up against Michael Jordan, they knew, hey, we're gonna get screwed over here. But what we can't do is play to their strength. We'll have them play our strength. So they can't screw us over. If they foul me out, they got another guy to deal with. If they try to get me out of the game or get him out of the game, we got another guy to step up. They gotta have their five guys on the court, so you can't just call fouls all day to bail the other team out. Somebody's gonna have to execute and actually perform and hit shots. We ran plays and actually scored on plays. That's what we were doing when we played. We persevered. The league didn't want us. We created an atmosphere to where the league had to have us. And that was it. And they keep talking about we were bad for basketball. We have the highest attendance in some of NBA basketball history, as far as final games and everything else for viewership, even today, buddy. So I just kind of let you know where we are now. But I've spoke long enough. Don't forget to support at Kwame Brown Bus Life. Kwame Brown Bus Life 2.0, Carcino for Life is here. One Crack News, all that. Subscribe, hit the notification bell. You know, all of this stuff is important for their algorithm, I guess. And I'm out the door, man. Shouts out to HD too and Seahawks Jose Rodriguez. Follow their channels. And Mondo Black TV, I don't know where he at. I gotta go check on him. And of course, Ticket TV, crazy stuff. So I'm out.